the green cellar slug. Believe it or not, most slugs are actually beneficial for your garden. There's about 40 different species in England alone. And actually, most slugs only eat dead or dying material, helping recycle the nutrients and making them more accessible to your plants. Having slugs in your compost heap is a really good thing and helps break all that stuff down, giving you beautiful fresh compost much quicker. So the green cellar slug, he actually only eats dead and dying, rotting things. He won't touch your living, alive plants. So the green cellar slug, he isn't a pest at all, and he won't munch on your plants. The green cellar slug actually mostly eats mold and algae. Unless, of course, he gets a scent for some pet food. And then you actually might find him in your pet bowl having a little munch. I think this personally oversteps the mark. The green cellar slug is not poisonous to humans or animals. But it's always very, very good to make sure you wash your hands really well after you've touched any kind of animal, because they can carry things like parasites and other things that could be harmful to you. A slug has thousands of microscopic teeth. The upper pair of tentacles are called the optical tentacles. And these are the eyes of a slug. The optical tentacles have light sensitive eye spots on the end and can be regrown if lost. These are also used for smell. The lower pair are two smaller tentacles and are used for feeling and tasting. Gastropods have no sense of hearing, and that's exactly what a slug is. Slugs will sleep on and off for several hours at a time, but then may stay awake for 30 hours without a break. Slugs also hibernate depending on the weather conditions. They don't have a 24-hour cycle. And they don't depend on the days and nights as we do. So, what's a slug's vision like? Well, they cannot focus on actual images because their eye has no lens and they cannot see colour either. Can though distinguish between light and shadow, and their eyes cup shape allows them to determine the direction of the light. Did you know that slugs are actually attracted to certain smells, and one of these smells is citrus? They love citrus so much that it can actually be a really sneaky way to trap slugs humanely. Three main things that attract slugs: moisture, food sources, and certain smells. Slugs rely heavily on moisture. Their survival really relies on it. They cannot allow themselves to dry out. Therefore, gardens provide the ideal place where slugs can thrive. Gardens that have moisture and provide plenty of warmth are the best for slugs. There are plenty of shady places where slugs can hide during the day. Gardens also have plants, foliage, fruits and vegetables, which slugs love. So what conditions attract a slug? Slugs really do not like sun. They are not into tanning at all. They don't like to be on dry or arid grounds. So, if your garden has plenty of shady areas and plenty of nice little moisture traps, then these are the conditions that will attract your slug. What other smells may attract slugs, you ask? Famously, slugs love beer. Therefore, many people use it in beer traps to capture them. But this really is not a nice and humane way to attract a slug. The problem is they drink the beer, fall in whilst a little bit tipsy and drown. So you may be saying, I really don't want to be attracted any more slugs. What don't they like? So here's a few things that a slug is repulsed by. Lavender and rosemary. Both of these herbs are powerful, fragrant, scented plants which are said to keep slugs at bay. On the contrary, some smells repel slugs, like pet hair, coffee grounds and herbs like rosemary and lavender. Another reason why a slug may be really good for your garden is caterpillars. Slugs hate them and will fend them off. And as we all know, there's nothing more devastating to a garden than caterpillars. Caterpillars are seen as intruders, and a slug is highly territorial and just will not stand for it. How far can a little slug like this travel? Well, these gluttonous little creatures consume several times of their own weight in plant material every day, and they can easily travel 40 feet to feed. You may have heard that one really clever way of getting rid of a slug or snail is by throwing it over the fence to the neighbours. Well, not only is this going to get you into a whole heap of trouble with your neighbours, but the little fella also has a homing instinct, so he's coming right the way back. A much better idea is to pop them onto your compost heap and allow them to munch their way and do a really good job of helping you out. The green cellar slug, in appearance, has a distinct olive greenish grey and yellow mottled or blotched patterning. The appearance of the very same slug can be quite different from different lighting and how the animal is reacting to its surroundings. When they curl up and make themselves really small and hard, they'll be much different colour and appearance to when they are outstretched. The habitat of the green cellar slug is most commonly associated in the house or in the garden. The green cellar slug can quite easily get 13 centimetres at maturity. Appearance of the green cellar slug's mucus is usually tinged slightly with yellow, orange, or entirely colourless. Juveniles, green cellar slug is darker in colour, considered a may pest. Appeal less it mottled. It will not attack or eat your living plants. It will regularly eat mould and algae and is often found in your compost heap. The green cellar slug was first properly recognised as its own species of slug in the 1970s, first in Ireland and spreading quickly through the UK. The green cellar slug, since then, records of the yellow cellar slug have declined sharply. So, has the green cellar slug taken over?